welcome back to my channel. Thank you so much for being here today. So I am so freaking excited for today's video because I literally love every single piece that is in this thrift haul. So if you've been watching my channel for a while, I don't do thrift hauls that often because all of my clothes are thrifted. However, I don't actively go to the thrift shop just because I have so much going on and it's just time consuming to go thrifting. However, in the art residency that I'm at right now, they actually have a thrift shop on site. So I'll go to lunch and then after lunch I'll be I'm just gonna walk over to the thrift shop and see what they have. And they just had some really amazing pieces. I feel like the haul is a really good mix too of staple pieces that I need, like high-waisted trousers and things like that for back to school. And pieces that I found that are really funky that I have thrift clipped. So yeah, I'm gonna be showing you these pieces, but also how I would style them with the hair, the accessories, everything, which I love. I love getting dressed up, as you guys know. And also, it's extremely hot today in Paris. Donc, si vous entendez le ventilateur, je suis désolée, mais franchement, c'est pas possible. Il fait trop chaud. So that brings me to today's video sponsor, which is Native. So I have been using Native deodorants for a few weeks now, and I'm super excited about them because not only are they all natural, but they're also vegan and cruelty-free. They're also made with natural ingredients like shea butter and coconut oil, and they smell literally so amazing, you guys. So they have a bunch of different scents that you can choose from, but I personally chose coastal oak and amber, lavender and rose, and my personal favorite, which is coconut and vanilla. I'm a sucker for anything vanilla, so this smells like, it literally smells like a candle. It's so good. And as somebody who is on the go a lot and whose job is physically demanding sometimes, what I really love about this deodorant is it's fast drying and it's long lasting even after a day in my hot art studio. So that's something I really appreciate. So a pack of three costs $36, but if you use the code PURPLEPALACE and follow the link down below, you can get them for $24, which is a 33% discount. So thank you so much to Native, and I hope that you guys will love these as much as I do. Okay, so without further ado, let's get into the haul. Okay, so the first piece that I'm gonna show you guys, I'm so freaking excited about. They are these high-waisted trousers, and they're originally from Max Mara. I got them at the thrift shop on site, like most of these pieces. I think I got them for €3, and they're high-waisted, amazing canvas type fabric. And I just love the way that they hit, and I like pairing them with this top, which I also thrifted because it has this monochromatic look, and I just feel very businessy when I wear it. And I felt really lucky because it's so hard when you're thrifting sometimes to find a piece that fits you perfectly, but they're super comfortable and I know I'm gonna wear them all of the time. So these are definitely a favorite. And to go along with those, I found the most amazing sheer long sleeve top. It's really cool because I have a lot of tattoos that are kind of hidden on my body, but because the top is sheer, you can kind of see them through the top. And I would pair it with these purple glasses that actually Alex got, and I stole them from him because I just felt it was more my vibe. But yeah, this was also from that thrift shop. I actually found it in the kids section, and that is an amazing tip, is sometimes the people who are taking the clothes, they don't really know if it's an extra small women's size or if it's an extra large kid size. So sometimes you can find a really nice fitting crop top in the kids section. So next is the dress that I'm wearing right now, and I tried to save this dress for this thrift haul and not show too much of it, but honestly I couldn't because I've just been wearing it so much this summer. So you might have seen it on my Instagram stories and stuff. Right now I'm styling it with these earrings that I have DIY'd. My little rosebud earrings. Honestly, these are so easy to DIY. Just take fake roses and cut them and then make a little hole and voila! I love this dress because it reminds me of like Hawaiian tropical punch. So personally, I love pairing dresses like this with like big chunky shoes. The shoes that you're seeing in this video aren't thrifted, they're from Vagabond. I don't really like thrifting shoes just because every time I thrift shoes, like literally they fall apart and like I find myself like in the middle of like the freaking metro or supermarket with like a shoe that's like half open and I have to like walk home barefoot and it's like disgusting. So shoes are basically the only thing that I don't really like to thrift. But anyway, getting back to the dress, I just love the colors. They're extremely summery and cheery. I've worn this dress to like barbecues and I think it's really feminine and pretty, but it's super, super comfortable as well. And I can also see myself wearing this in winter with like a big chunky faux fur coat, and I just love like the little buns. So this dress wasn't actually thrifted. It was gifted to me by this elderly lady, a friend of the family's, and she always gives me like bags of clothes, which is even better. And it's so nice like when people, like friends, they give you the clothes that they don't want anymore, just because like you find yourself like actually trying styles that you would normally try. And I don't think that I would normally pick this up at the thrift shop. So you guys have to find like that person in your life that's like older and has like really nice like vintage pieces they don't want to wear anymore, because honestly it's so, so nice. Every time she gives me a piece, and she wears really nice perfume too, so I'm like, oh, smells so good, such good vibes. Okay, next I have this gorgeous yellow painter's canvas jacket. I don't know if you would call it a jacket, I guess it's like a little vest. And I found this as well at the thrift shop, €3. And I really love drawing on my clothing. As y'all know, if you follow my vintage shop, I just love like adding that little personal touch. So I decided to draw these little flowers on it. And I love pairing this yellow with a purple kind of flared pants. It gives me like Kill Bill vibes. And I just feel like super funky when I wear this outfit. And I also love pairing it as well with the purple sunglasses that I showed you guys. I wore my hair in these pigtails because I feel like it really offsets the look. That's something that I really like to do with my outfits, is like find a way to have like contradictions and things. For example, I feel like the outfit is very like Kill Bill or like Charlie's Angels vibes, like badass vibes, but like the pigtails gives it kind of like a girly twist. And love pairing it with these chunky shoes, purple flared pants, and yeah, it's like one of my favorite looks. So next I have these amazing overalls that I DIY'd. So these were actually thrifted from Garisol. This summer I actually decided to bleach them and do like a bleach tie-dye. So that was something that I discovered during the quarantine, is bleach tie-dyeing. But yeah, basically you just take bleach and you just put it all over the overalls or the jeans or whatever. It gives it this really cool faded look. I put a little too much like on the crotch area, so I feel like it kind of looks like I pissed myself, but that's fine. it's a vibe. And I was originally gonna put them on my vintage shop, but I realized that like the clasps at the top, they have like a weird problem that I don't know how to fix, like they're all twisted and stuff. So what I decided to do is pin these like huge flowers on top, and it gives like this very sweet like Miss Honey from Matilda vibe. You know, like it reminds me of like your neighbor that like is like always outside gardening her flowers, and she's like, do you guys want a cookie? And I really love pairing it with that sheer top that I showed you guys, because I remember when I was younger, I used to get really jealous that like all the boys could wear overalls without anything under it, and I would have to wear like a shirt. But with this like top, it kind of matches my skin tone, so I feel like I'm just, you know, free wearing my overalls. So my next piece is this really amazing high-waisted pleated blue schoolgirl skirt, and I almost didn't get it because I have one that's extremely similar. And but when I tried it on, it's like a perfect fit. It fits me better than the other one that I had, and the fabric is super nice canvas fabric. It's extremely comfortable, and I feel like this is like the type of staple piece that I need in my wardrobe, like because I know it'll go so well in the winter with like big chunky sweaters, or like, you know, in the summer with like a kind of cropped tight top. So it's also really good for costumes. For example, the other one that I have that is similar to this I wore so many times for different costumes. For example, Sailor Moon, perfect skirt for Sailor Moon. I like the length of it. It's not too short. Like, I don't feel uncomfortable when I'm wearing it. And I think the pleats are really, really cute. It's one of those pieces that is just not going to go out of style. Okay, next is one of my favorite finds. I've been wearing it so much and I honestly already got a tomato sauce stain on it. That is just how I am. I always stain my clothes because I just like to live in my clothes, you know? And I'm not like too worried about like getting things on it because I just feel like your clothes, you're meant to wear them and that's life, you know? But yeah, I found this also at the thrift shop here, and it was, I had already bought the things that I wanted to buy, but I saw this on my way out and it just like caught my eye. It's like this candy colored pastel button down dress and it's so soft. It's made in France. It's made by Marcel. And the quality is amazing. It's just like one of those dresses that's like, it's cute, but at the same time, it's super comfortable. I love throwing it on like when I'm painting or just like doing anything. It's very lightweight for this summer, so I don't feel like, you know, it's too dressy. And I love how certain clothes can like boost your mood. Like when I wear this, I feel like more bubbly and happy. And I feel like it also affects the people around you because they're like, oh, you look happy today. Okay, this next piece I am so excited to show you guys because I think that it is so unique and just really, really freaking cool. So, I thrifted this long black gown at the thrift store that's on site in my art residency. So when I got it, it was just all black, but I used puffy paint to do like these really cool like stars and moons all over it. When I saw it, it made me like think of a very like witchy type dress or like something that would be like really cool and like badass to like wear with like clunky black shoes. I just, makes me feel a certain type of way when I wear it, and I think like that is the goal of clothes. Or, like, it's supposed to help you find a certain feeling that you want to express. I painted these little stars and moons, and at the top I wrote dream because I wanted this dress to give me like a certain feeling of power and just like, you know, when I wear it, to feel like this feminine, powerful energy, you know? I can just totally imagine myself like on a dark evening in Paris, like walking down the Seine and like just feeling like really moody or whatever. And I haven't painted the back of it yet, but I actually think that I'm gonna leave it like that because I really like that if somebody sees me from the back, I'm gonna like turn around and they're gonna be like, whoa, like they're not gonna be expecting like all of this craziness. And I like I said, like I really like contradictions, and that's true in my artwork as well as like the outfits that I choose to wear as well. And I think it's really important that like the outfits that you have, they, you know, they express who you are inside as well. And I think that all of us have contradictions in ourselves, so that's why I really love this dress and I'm really proud to wear it. Okay, so this next piece I really love too. It's also made in Paris by the brand Antonelle, and it had this really cute button-up collar. And since I really liked the kind of flower motif that I did on the yellow piece that I showed you, I decided that I want to do a couple more motifs like that so that if I decided to, I could put a few on my vintage shop. So I made this one and I think it's really sweet. I did red spray paint on this one and just like these really big flowers. So I really like getting white pieces because you can either draw on them and customize them that way, or you can wear them and just let life customize them. For example, I have white blouses that I buy and I just wear them while I paint, and inevitably over time I get like paint marks on them, and I think it just looks really sweet because it's not like something that you try to do, it just like happens. I would either wear this piece with like some baggy jeans or maybe under like a black spaghetti dress or something like that. And it has a very sweet vibe, unlike the one in yellow. I feel like the one in yellow is more like powerful, but this one has a very sweet vibe, and that's why I kind of paired it with like this farm girl bandana, and it's definitely one of my favorite pieces. So if you guys like the way this looks, send me a DM and I can maybe customize one like this that is similar because they're really fun to make. This next piece is a very sweet and simple summery dress. I can see myself like running through a field in this dress, and just has a really nice fit. I think that the flowers on it are really cute. It also has that kind of 90s vibe. I love pairing it with clunky shoes. And I think it's really fun in summer to have like these lightweight, very feminine dresses. Okay, so this next piece I actually got with the intention of drawing on or doing some DIY stuff, but it actually was so lightweight and sweet that I decided just to like leave it as is because I honestly don't have that many like just simple white tops. And even on really hot days, it's extremely comfortable. I love the collar and just like the kind of fresh cotton feeling it has, you know, when I wear it. I really like to wear it with like my hair free, with like some baggy jeans, and it just has a very kind of summery, putting the clothes on the line type vibe, you know? The question is now, how long can I actually keep it white? Because I love chocolate ice cream and painting, and I always get shit all over my clothes. Okay guys, this next dress was also gifted to me by that lady who gave me a bag of clothing that I talked about earlier with this dress. And you can tell she has a certain style of dresses she likes, but I really like this one because it's spaghetti strap, it has like these beautiful white flowers on it, and it's just perfect for summer. It's very feminine, and just like with chunky black shoes, I feel like it's just very, very cool for like, you know, dinners and things like that. And it has like this little gold detailing, and I think it's really, really pretty. I love dresses that are spaghetti strap like this because in winter time you can easily put like a black long sleeve sweater under it or turtleneck, and it's just extremely versatile. Okay, the last piece that I have for you guys today for this haul is this gorgeous cream white blazer. And yes, I also drew on it, and I think that like compared to the other pieces, the drawings on this blazer is especially cool just because I feel like normally blazers are meant to be like professional and things like that, so to have that kind of surprise of a doodle on it and like spray paint and things like that, I think that it gives it this really cool edge, you know? And I think that when you work in an office or like you're a businesswoman, you kind of get put into this box of like professional looks like this. But I also think it's cool that you can kind of add twists to what being professional really is. Like, being professional doesn't mean like wearing only black and gray. Like, you could totally wear this blazer with like, you know, some really slick black pants or even like cream pants. That would be really cool. And I think that it's important, like even if you do have like a desk job, to sort of find a way to insert your personality and like some funkiness into your outfit if that is how you truly feel inside. So I like to pair it with like these laid back jeans that I love. Like, these are honestly my favorite pair of jeans, and I've had them forever. They have like paint stains all over them, and I think it adds a really cool contrast. But yeah, I did purposely make a few with the same motif because I really like the motif, and I wanted to be able to put some on my vintage shop Instagram as well. So if that interests you guys, you can follow me on there. And if not, that pretty much concludes this thrift haul. I was so excited to share it with you guys because I just love putting together outfits, and I think that fashion can be a really cool way of expressing yourself even further. And if this could inspire you guys in some way to, you know, DIY things yourself, go thrifting, and just experiment with clothing, then I think that's awesome. So don't forget to subscribe if you want to see some more videos from me in French and in English. And I'm also on Patreon, so if you want to support what I'm doing here, or if you want extra content like podcast episodes, blog posts, or meetups around Paris, you can find all that info linked down below. I love you guys so much, and I hope that you have a beautiful week. See you soon. Bye. today, of all days, you choose to do construction.